We will use now this time for some small presentation what is global engineering. Some people asking me and Dietrich, what is global engineering and what is reason of this course. One of you was already in global engineering. One of you was already in global coaching clinic.
Which global?
My first edition. My first edition. From this first edition, is a little bit changed. We will tell you what is changed. Global coaching clinic was starting approximately 7 years ago, and it was idea of President Dr. Hassan Mustafa to bring in IHF level highest education for coaches. Little bit about this history. It was decision making in Basel, you can read it, about the president I spoke. It was decided that first course will be in Asia, and it was established working group. It was Dietrich Petter, it was Zoltán Vachinka and me. We have meeting in the Prague. 2 days, and we make some preparation. It was this meeting in Prague, or it was 3 days. We spoke about conception, about program, about action plan, and the first draft for invitation letter was made. We have a little bit organizational problems by the start, because we have to start in Bahrain, and because some problems, political problems in this time in Bahrain, we received possibility to start in Qatar, and the second part was what name of this town?
Moscow.
The first course was 8 days. Second was 6 days. We have possibility also to invite some lecture more, because was more as 40 people, exactly 44 or 45 people, and because it was necessary to make also translation from English to Arabic, it was two language using, we was 4, plus these 3 people, plus Nabil Taha from Bahrain. This excellent lecture, and he was also translating English to Arabic. Also, 2 languages, mostly was coming people from Arabic Africa and this East, Nahe East, this East from look of Europe, this more East Asia, from this Arabic country, which are more close to Mediterranean. First course, all participants must pay everything. And we have some extra people. It was 2 persons from France. This, I forgot name. He was responsible for defense in France, and second was responsible for physical preparation. It was, I think, very interesting to have these people there. But after first course, something changed, because we have to go to Africa, and Africa have not so much possibility, as North Africa and this rich country around gold. Also, Africa was a little bit changing the conception. Africa people receive possibility that everything what was concerning accommodation and concerning stay was paid by IHF, like here. Unfortunately, no travel cost. We was trying to change a little bit, that travel cost sometimes is more expensive. It was better and for everybody safe to pay accommodation and travel have to be paid, but okay, it was not possible to change. In Africa, it was a little bit in different way. We was starting in two groups. I was together with Zoltán Marcinka in Johannesburg, and it was from Anglophone country, and Paul Landure, because Dietrich had no possibility this time to be involved, with Ben Kreira, maybe you know, is from Algeria, living in Canada. He was together with Paul Landure for Francophone group. But it was already like now, it was for national coaches. It was for national coaches. And therefore, because this philosophy a little bit changed, we have also a little bit different attitude. Not everybody was invited for second part. From approximately 45 people was invited for second part only 20. And second part was by Africa Games in Congo Brazzaville. We have in Africa also a little bit problem with organization. Firstly, was not so easy to find organizer. And secondly, then was starting this Ebola problem, and we have to postpone against this course. But Africa was happy for it, because was coming World Championship in Qatar, and all these people was invited free of charge to come to Qatar and to look World Championship in Qatar. Because Qatar was given to IHF possibility to invite 1,000 people. Imagine, they pay everything. They pay for 1,000 people, they pay travel cost, and they pay stay. IHF have problem to fulfill it. Each national federation received possibility to take 16 journalists, for example. Czechia have problem to find 16 journalists which are writing about handball. It was coming only day. We organize seminar for presidents. We organize seminar for general secretary. We organize big coaching symposium, and part of this coaching symposium was also people from Africa coming. Was different meetings, was meeting lecture of CCM, a lecture of PRC, the referee, was meeting for ladies, special meeting for ladies. And by the end, Vice President Mikel Ruka, because the coach from Qatar is also from Spain, invited maybe 40 spectators from Spain. Although it was a little bit different situation. Then was coming Panamerica. Panamerica was also in two languages. It was Spain and English. And the first part was in Mexico and second part was in Auburn, in USA, Alabama. University, excellent place, because like here is hidden everything. It was also a lot, not so much, but also a lot. But first of all, it is university in which is cooperating with USA Olympic Committee, and both USA handball team, mostly by men, they are students of this university. Also, we can work with men, university team, it was demonstration team. And now, finally, was coming this middle and east part of Asia, plus some from Oceania. Also, if you are asking which level is it, it is global coaching clinic level. And we have in the plan that second part will be in Korea, hopefully.
Yeah. We will organize it with Mr. Thomas.
But
he's member in the CCA.
But before this second part in Korea, which must be 8 days, then we will be, I think, we will be not able to invite everybody. And it will be depending what we will, which feedback we will receive about you. Curriculum vitae, it is only helping. It is not deciding. But deciding will be what we will see during these 6 days and what you will send us later, because you will receive homework. Like it was in Qatar, and like was in Africa, like was in Panamerica. You will receive homework and you must send this homework to us in advance. There will be also some short test here. And it is the reason why we need to distribute at least tomorrow evening this first PowerPoint presentation. Yeah? To have possibility that everybody receive it and everybody can look a little bit. Terminology, etc., etc. Homework is important, because in homework it is not only writing one selected training lesson, but it is also to take this training lesson on the video record, to show in this video record what is most important. No, not 90 minutes, but what is most important, around 20 minutes extra from your lesson. And you must send also this DVD or extra USB to us. Also, you will receive this information later, yeah?
So in detail. Yeah. But the idea is that we can see how you are working in practice. And we have a good experience with this homework. It's really interesting. And also, when we come together in the second part, we will discuss each practical lesson. We will receive feedback. What is good, okay, what you are, maybe you can do a little bit better. So we have a great experience with this homework. It is more practical. Not only theory.
So it is a little bit about content. This is a little bit about practice. You will receive it also. It is some program. 8 plus 6, now is 6 plus 8. Here is teaching unit. Here is teaching unit 45. We have 85, two teaching units together. Part 1, part 2. It is some action plan. It was for Doha, Qatar. It is with president in Oman. People which was in they was also happy because you was fierce and you receive also sound equipment. Yeah. It is this gentleman from France. No, yeah. It is the second one. These are participants. That is second part.
Also some women?
Oh, yeah. Emil? Yeah. He was from Qatar, I assume. Okay, it is all. And we have second topic. We have time for it, and I was starting because if I give word to Dietrich, I will not come on the podium anymore. It is about system of education in IHF. It is something what we was trying to do together, starting already nearly 2.5 years ago in Denmark, continuing. Now we have 2016 was approved by council, and last year was coming also as IHF regulation. Also, I will open this IHF regulation. And I will open this schema, yeah? It's pyramid. This is maybe also interesting. Starting with pyramid.
You can receive it also, you can read it, it's written all in detail, it's not necessary to discuss.
We will give you also, yes, if you want.
That is now official, it's our official IHF regulation. It was also approved in the last Congress in Turkey, and it is now official. So, but the main idea is this pyramid.
And only one remark. We hope that you, it is not important if you will continue in second part or if you are finishing after first part, that you have to be also multiplicator. You have been educator which in at least in your country or in your continent. Yeah. Maybe later we will speak a little bit more about it.
Okay. I have only short remarks. Also, you will receive the material, you can read it, all details. At first, it's important for all which knows a little bit about the European coaches license system. At the end, it is similar to this. It is very similar to this. So that was for us very important to have nearly a same structure, only some small differences, so that we are compatible with the European license system. That is important. So that's the first reason. The idea behind this, explained it in the last 2 days very well. Look at first to the target groups, We want the first license for the basis are all coaches or teachers which have this topic introduction of handball. This means mini handball. This means children, boys and girls in the schools, promotion of the sport, to win that. That is the idea of the first level. And for this, we have a special project. I said it, I will explain it again. This is the name is Handball at School. I think it's one of the most successful projects which IHF ever made and created. It's so successful. We have a lot of courses worldwide. IHF spent a lot of money. Again, the structure of handball in school. And that is an important information, at least for all of you. The idea is one lecture from IHF. We have a special working group which is responsible for content. We have now a new working group. And this new working group is working very hard for new teaching material. We come back, hopefully, then we have the final meeting, hopefully in Prague, in this nice city, and then we will finish off. And round about 3 months later, middle of the year, at the new teaching material. That is very important. Immediately you can translate it. I'm looking to you, for example, China or others. You immediately can use this material for translation. It will be really nice. So that is the material. This group, we have a group, and we have a group of lectures. Different from different countries, different languages. So, and the idea is, if you ask IHS for a handball at school course for this D-level, the organization is like this. One lecture is coming, and you have to organize at three different places. Could be more, but minimum three different places to organize a course for teachers or for coaches responsible for beginners. Could be 50, 60, or more. Yeah. 3 days on one place, 3 days, then all are traveling to the next place, 3 days, and the next place. So it's very successful. You can reach a lot of target groups, a lot of people. So, and the big advantage is IHF paid everything for the lecture. Also the material, you receive a lot of squeeze boards, for example, a lot of small boards for children, other materials. So IHF invests a lot of money. So it's also, at the same time, you receive a lot of good and new equipment. It's also good. And this new teaching material. So at the end, everyone, if they are successful, then everyone gets this D license. It's only 25 teaching units. It is more to win people, teacher, for our sport. It is more promotion. But I think it's a good idea. So, and then you receive immediately the D license. And the idea behind is to motivate them to go up. If they want to stay with the sport, then they can go up. So at the same time, it's promotion to catch some good people for our sport. Okay, you understand? We think about this. Maybe at the end we can discuss this. you can try to create a project in your country. So handball at school. Okay, and now the idea of the next level is the content and the target. That is, for me, you know, every time I'm speaking about basic and advanced training, you see it here in the coaches education license system. The second part, the C licenses, is focused to basic training. This means 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, or about 15 years old players. That is the main topic of basic training. Also, in this 16 training unit, some basic methodical information, some basic information, but the main focus is the target. And that is that are players which are in the called basic. Okay? We have a lot of experience in Germany with this and in Europe to have a license system concerning, depending to the target groups, to develop youth and human training. That is the idea behind. So, next, it's clear the B license is focused to advanced training. Okay. So today in the practice, this target group is the last target group for advanced training, 15, 16, 17, 18 years old. And at the end, we are going to more top training, to the more professional training. This is then really the top level. And the idea is also with the GCC course going a little bit through this level than to the top, especially in the second part of the course. So that is the main idea. And if you receive IHF license, then you can do a lot with it. You can do, if you want to go to Germany, you show the license, then it's clear. You can, if you are able, you can train maybe as a club in the second division. That is for this company. That is clear, that's the official license. Nearly the same what the European Federation is doing. Okay? So the aim at the end is that we all reach maybe the ELAT, so hopefully. Okay?
So guys,
the rest is a lot of details, but you can reach.
Yeah, maybe because we have a little bit more time. Maybe also what is a little bit behind. Because you know, Europe is a continent which have a clear education system. I have possibility to be by the start because I was 12 years responsible in Europe for method and teaching commission. And we was starting with six countries. It was France, it was Denmark, it was German, Hungary, Russia and Czechia. We was starting with six countries and it was big discussion how to construct this education system, because three former West country, three former East country, all country with good handball tradition, but completely different education system. In East country was everything was coming on the top, organized by universities. Everything was organized by universities. In cooperation with the handball bodies in this country, but it was highest education level was university study. It was not in Denmark. Completely different was in German. German have Leipzig in east, German have Köln in west, and completely different was in France, because in France was also under umbrella of this talk, under umbrella of government. Yeah. Also, it was really very difficult to find the same attitude. Also, we was trying to make what is minimum. Everything that you saw on this pyramid is minimum.
Minimum.
Can be more. Yeah. And now we have in Europe, nearly all Europe countries are involved. No, all countries are involved in highest level, but they are involved already in this education system. And our idea is, does Europe must ask International Handball Federation that International Handball Federation give accreditation to Europe that what is doing Europe that is accepted also from IHF. It was reason that we was trying to do it compatible. And we hope that another continent will follow. If will be another continent not follow, then we hope that at least some national federation will follow. And our idea is, you have coaching license, but you can receive also accreditation as lecturer on different level. If you will have the highest level, you have at least accreditation to be lecturer in level B. Maybe also in level A. And if continent or if some federation is doing some education program and doing it without accreditation from IHF, they can do it, but they didn't receive IHF certificate. But if this continent or if this country sent to CCM, IHF CCM program, clear program, and who will be lecturer, and this lecturer have accreditation from IHF, in this moment, all participants can receive IHF certificate. Also, it is also a little bit behind. A little bit to more understand, it is not so easy. Africa was starting very well. Africa have already lectures group of lectures. Unfortunately, mostly Francophone. They are trying to bring also Anglophone people inside, but they are starting to work. Asia, what I know, Asia is CCM only on the paper. Pan-American, nothing. Nothing. Oceania is difficult. Yeah. But it's necessary one time to start. Europa was starting 18 years ago. Also, you are a little bit ahead. Because Europa is always a global continent. But you have to be better as Europe. Don't forget.
Can I ask a question? What's the difference between this global coaching clinic and the master coach, what they are doing in Europe?
It will be not any more different. If, because highest level of IHF is master coaching clinic. Yeah? And it is same level like master coach in Europe. Yeah? And Europe has agreement who is in this ring convention and their diploma from Germany, this diploma must be accepted also in France or in Russia or in Czechia and opposite. And
but an IHF is in full board.
It showed me it is different word, different name, but level is same. Yeah? Okay, some question. You can have question also for another things if you want. We have 5 minutes more, please.
How do you matriculate to those levels? So, for example, if you've got coaches here and there hasn't been a conventional path to get certificates, like you said, in India, how do these coaches achieve these levels? Do like a national team coach, will they have to start at level D and work up afterward from now on?
It is depending, please. If you will reading it, is depending of coaching experience also.
Okay.
It's not possible to do in 3 days or 4 levels.
Yeah.
Why? Because we expect that you have not only education, that you have also some coaching experience. And between levels D and C must be at least 3 years experience. Between C and B must be at least 3 years experience. We are doing same in world. I have students in my university which have eight semester have handball, but they did not receive after 8 semester the highest level. They received diploma, but they don't receive this license. Diploma is a little bit different. Yeah. They must wait, and after that they have enough practice, they receive also this highest level. Also, it is, we know, for people which have already experience, we must do it a little bit faster. You will be sure not starting with D. You understand me? You will be sure not starting with C. But only people which have at least 9 years experience as coach, at least 9 years experience, and people which will be successful in this global coaching clinic, they will receive immediately this highest level. It is understandable? Okay. Thank you for this question, and we have possibility to go for the dinner.
And we continue questions from Texas. A lot of people have questions. Also the lady from... I'm speaking to you. So, you see? We will, your question tomorrow in the meeting.
Okay? Tomorrow, yeah.
Everything is okay? Okay.
It is general. We are very happy if you are coming with a question. But most of these questions are important for everybody, not only for you. And it's better to discuss in a group. Yeah? So after tomorrow we will always have this consultation here in this room. Enjoy your meal. Thank you.